Okay, guys, back to the scene of the crime. Right, so, sorry I ended off the last video abruptly. We're on the second phase of Metroid Prime here. And we're just gonna go ahead and scan him first, for convenience sake. Let's go get some health, too, because he dropped some health pickups, which we can go ahead and collect. If he would stay out of my face. Oh, hang on a second. Wait, has he? No, he hasn't done the thing yet. I thought he would have done, but he hasn't. So, alright, this is where he's going to turn invisible. Now, what you have to do here, you have to switch to either one of your visors, and he'll show up in either one of them. In this case, it's the X-ray visor. Now, what you want to do is stand in this pool, the Phazon, and use the Phazon beam. Although, you can't really see it in the visor, it looks a lot cooler when you attack him with your visor off, and you're just using the normal vision, because you can actually see the beam a lot more clearer that way. He's invisible right now, so I'm gonna switch to Phazon. The freaking X-ray visor, dude. Alright, so he's made another pool. And is he gonna go invisible again? Okay, so he's now in the thermal vision. So this is how you take him down until you eventually defeat him. But at some point in this fight, he's gonna start using Metroids to help him out. So that's when things are gonna start getting tricky. That's why I wanted to save my freaking power bombs. And that's not the visor I wanted to use, the scan visor. No, not that one. Alright, here we go. He's got. Well, these are normal Metroids. You can take care of these just regular if you want to, but he'll start using fission Metroids, which are the ones you really want to look out for, because like I say, they split up, and this is what the Phazon beam actually looks like. Honestly, when I did this for the first time, like actually get into this fight doing it for the first time, I thought this was like the most epic shit I ever did in any video game. It was so awesome. Alright, I'm gonna take care of those with a super missile. Get some power bombs back here, thank god. At least they were kind enough to give us those. And he's already down to half health, so that's good. Yeah, you're just having to dodge a series of these shockwaves that he sends out at you, and then wait for him to transition to the next visor, which he should do, hopefully, very shortly, because this is just dragging out the fight, dragging out the inevitable, because you are going to die, whether you like it or not, as much as you don't want to. Oh, he's gone back to normal mode? Oh, okay. I don't know why he transitioned to thermal. Then, okay, now he's going again, back to X-ray. Dude, are you gonna, you know, make the pool of Phazon anytime soon? Man, he's playing a game of, oh no, change. Playing a game of guess the visor, that's what you do. Alright, here we go, super missile. Take care of that, and take care of the Hunter Metroid with another one if I can in time, which I can't. You can also try and kill the Metroids using the Phazon beam if you're lucky. But if you manage to get them in your range, you can try and kill them that way. I am really desperate to use the bathroom right now. I should have gone pee, man. I should have gone pee before I started doing this. Because, it's really throwing me off, but what I'll probably do is I'll pause, the recording, like, towards the end of the boss fight, and what I'll do is end off the video there, because I don't want to go through the credits, and then halfway through the credits have to friggin' stop the video, close AMCAP, and then reopen AMCAP again. I don't want to do that, so, probably going to end up pausing the video anyway. I used a super missile on you, why did that not kill? Okay, is he in... Right, he's in x-ray vision. Crap. I took a fair amount of unnecessary damage just then. Wait, is that a pick? Yeah, that is a pickup. I don't know what that is. Alright, so what we got here? Here we go. Fission Metroid. Alright, get your power bombs ready. And take care of that. Alright, so I think he's an x-ray. No, not x-ray, thermal, sorry. Okay, where's the pool? Wait, did I miss it? No, I didn't. What the hell? Okay, now... What's it doing, dude? Jeez. Because the pool of Phazon eventually disappears if you, you know, stand around it too long and don't walk over it and use it for its purpose. Like, if you just leave it there and you don't actually managed to get the Phazon beam out in time, it can disappear, so you gotta be careful of that. I don't think the credits are that long, so I should be able to get it all in one video if I make the cut, you know. Please say I got both. Two birds with one stone. Yes, I did. Ugh. You are going to die! Okay, he's almost dead. Right, I think this is a good place to end off, because I'm going to end up running out of time if I go into the credits, as I am right now, so I'm going to pause it, and I'm going to go to the toilet, and I'll be right back. So, just hang on a second, and I'll see you in the next video. This is NDM, saying thanks for watching, take everybody soon in the next video, and goodbye.